All right, we're back. Dynasty Trades in Five. I'm Clay.
I'm Shane. I was fixing my hair when we came on. I don't know if anyone noticed that.
I'm Scott. Looks this great. Is episode 48. Then that would be Elijah Moore's number times six. There you go. A little math.
There we go. There we go.
I still don't know what his number is.
He's number eight.
Exactly. Just testing you.
All right. So we're doing Elijah Moore tonight. Clearly he's a hot name right now. Apparently he's day to day with a quad. So we'll see, if he plays this weekend, but this is a dynasty show. So we're going to talk about, Elijah Moore, what we think. Scott, you're up, sir.
Yeah. So if he doesn't play this week, then his value has dropped at least 20%. Cause that's just how things are. So you just don't, if he's ruled out by the time this video gets released, you know, don't go out there and think that his value is what we talked about. It's down at least 20% cause he's not going to be playing anyway. We can do a whole other probably video on like that new trend in Dynasty. But no, Elijah Moore, you know, just looking at DLF ADP, wide receiver 33. I think we talked about him when we did the Rashad Bateman video, and we kind of laughed about how low that ADP was compared to what it really is on the open market. I think at this point, you know, considering that we are 3/4 of the way through the season, like we can already call Elijah Moore's rookie season a success. So if you're going to say, did he hit as a rookie? Yes, he's checked pretty much every box, especially if you consider he's had three different quarterbacks. Then that's not even the starter that he was supposed to be with. So technically, he's had four different quarterbacks that have played in games for the Jets, because we all remember the Josh Johnson game where he came in halfway through. That was the Elijah Moore breakout game. But no, he's wide receiver 31 in points per game. Tied with the likes of Brandon Cooks, Amari Cooper, A.J. Brown, Darnell Mooney. He's a rookie, 21-year-old rookie, was an early declare. His profile checked all the boxes. He was the youngest receiver in the class. So to see him already producing at this level, like it's pretty much everything you would ask. That's why you draft the rookies that are 21, that are coming out early, that have a production profile in college. He's it. So really just the debate here is how high do you move him? But I think I'm ready to move him into that wide receiver two range in Dynasty. And then his ceiling is just going to be dependent on how good is Zach Wilson, how good is the offense, how good's the efficiency. I mean, I'm not a film guy. Everyone knows that. But a lot of the film guys have said, like, he can win in the slot and on the outside. He's a great route runner. So, I mean, I don't think there's anything negative. I think if you said he was in your top 15, I couldn't argue with it, just considering how murky that range is.
We talked about when he was coming out of college, or at least tape guys talked about, was he can play outside or inside, and he's done that. He's played mostly outside. I do wonder, I mean, the Jets have to get another wide receiver next year, right? I mean, they can't count on Corey Davis. Denzel Mims is already, I think, gone, right? They haven't cut him yet, but he's gone in spirit. But all that said, if someone were to offer me Elijah Moore and a premium pick for DJ Moore, I'd be ready to move off DJ Moore, because it looks like Elijah Moore can do more with bad quarterback play than DJ Moore can. I'm disappointed I don't have as much Elijah Moore in my leagues as I should. Unfortunately, I went with a lot of Trey Sermon in that area. That doesn't feel good. But yeah, it's hard not to be positive about him, but I guess it's all about price point. So you got to hope that he has a couple bad games, because like Scott said, he's already over 530 yards receiving. So he's over that 500 yard threshold we look for rookies. His ADP is clearly not going to drop in the offseason. It's only going to go up. So everything about him indicates that he's going to be a hit. It's just how much do you want to pay for him?
So would you go Elijah Moore in an early 22 seconds or Diontae Johnson?
I'm going with Johnson's just because Elijah Moore is what I hope, or Diontae Johnson is what I hope Elijah Moore can turn into.
I think he's clearly a better player than Diontae Johnson. It's just, will he ever get the opportunity slash be able to command the 150 plus targets that Diontae Johnson has commanded the past 2 years? I think that's the key. My strategy with these guys is I want shares of all of them, but I don't want to be stuck with too many. Cause right now, if you have the wrong shares, you're not able to even get to like Elijah Moore. Go try to trade Jerry Jeudy for Elijah Moore. Why would the person do that? That makes no sense to do. So that's bigger topic here.
Okay. Crossing positions. Would you rather have Elijah Moore or Josh Jacobs? We just did a show on him.
Elijah.
What about David Montgomery?
Moore.
Man, I'm such a Monty stan, but he is a running back. So probably more, and I should be able to get something else with more on that for David Montgomery, I think.
Okay, what about Elijah Moore or Joe Mixon?
More.
Yeah, I'd take more.
See, I think, Clay, you just asked with three running backs. In the now, if I need a running back, I'm probably more in more of dire straits with needing a running back right now.
Sure.
But as soon as that time flips to the offseason,
right,
you would do anything you can to get a first plus for any of those guys, and Elijah Moore is worth a first plus. So to sit here and say I wouldn't take a first plus in March for Joe Mixon, like, you're crazy. But in the now, I probably need Joe Mixon or David Montgomery more, so that's fair.
Yeah, and we also ran a poll on Twitter today. It was Rashad Bateman, who we did on our last show. Rashad Bateman in an early 22 second or Elijah Moore. And Elijah Moore won it 56% of the vote, 246 votes. So it's pretty wild considering they were taken right around the same spot as one another in the last rookie draft. Bateman oftentimes ahead of Elijah Moore.
Yeah, but one's hit and one hasn't. And
exactly.
I mean, and you can say, well, injuries or whatever, but right, Rashad Bateman's had six games to prove himself, and he hasn't yet. And I don't want to hear that he's a rookie and all that, because rookies that don't hit aren't going to hit, period, usually. And I love Bateman, and I drafted him over Moore as well. And if anyone in the world would take Bateman in a second from me for Elijah Moore, I would do it in an instant.
Well, I mentioned a name earlier, Jerry Jeudy. You can almost look back and say Elijah Moore's rookie year was similar to Jerry Jeudy. So it's different how we're treating these guys. People expected more from Jerry Jeudy because he was a first round pick. And even though he put up, what, 800 plus yards in his rookie year, it's like people thought he didn't do enough. Whereas Elijah Moore could end this year with 900 yards and we're going, what a season. He did it with Zach Wilson and three other quarterbacks and on the Jets, you know? So I think we have to be careful about how high we raise his value. But Jerry Jeudy was a wide receiver too after last year. And he's lingered in that range. He just hasn't ascended because his situation hasn't gotten any better. So I think that's an apt comparison. But there's some guys around him. I mean, if you can trade Calvin Ridley for Elijah Moore, just send it out and smash. You know, just send it out and take it. Forget about what Calvin Ridley was. Michael Pittman, same thing. You can trade him for Elijah Moore. Like, just send those straight up and see what the other person says.